सदाशिवसमारूढां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमामस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्परां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालीं करुणालीं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तमां दिशावहै शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यो ब्रह्माणुजाति पुरो वेदागश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तगुमहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः कामनायान्तिकसंसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तिवर्जितमानन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे सो लास्ट वी लुक्ड एट 3329 लिङ्गभूयस्त्वात् तद्धि बलीयस्तदपि सो बै मिस्टेक् ऐ एडेड् हू हियर् पूर्वपक्ष बट् इट् इस् अ सिद्धान्तसूत्र आफ् कोर्स् पूर्वपक्ष इस् मेन्शन्ड् इन् दि सिद्धान्तसूत्र सो वी हेव् सीन् दिस् स्टैल् अर्लियर् एस् टु the siddhanta is mentioned and then the purvapaksha follows in the purvapaksha sutra there are two purvapaksha sutras which follow then because the purvapaksha has been mentioned a summary kind of a sutra of siddhanta with an additional argument is given later so just to refresh linga bhuyastva tathi baliyastadapi Sutra said that linganam bhuyastvat. Siddhanti is saying because there are lot of lingas. The context is this pranachitaha, vakchitaha, all these are upasanas which are independent, says the Siddhanti. Purvapakshi is claiming and is going to explain his perspective as to why these are not independent upasanas. They have dependency on karma because they are karmanga. So, they are kriyartha, they are for the purpose of kriya. Based on that kriya, there are karmangas and these upasanas are anga to those. They have dependency on karmangas, therefore they are karmangas as well. They are not independent upasanas. And Siddhanti is answering, saying that linganam bhuyastvat. Because there are many a linga that show jnapaka shabdas are there, which reveal that the upasanas are independent and therefore as per the Purvamimamsaka Sutras, Jaimini Sutra says Shruti Linga Vakya Prakaranasthana Samakhya is the gradation of strength in analysis as to what is the resultant. So in concluding your analysis you have to consider Shruti as the strongest and Samakhya on the other end as the weakest. Linga is stronger only next to Shruti, therefore the Prakarana won't stand. The Prakarana won't stand as Pramana to conclude that the Vakya or Prakarana, Sthana, Samakhya, these will not stand as Pramana to conclude that Upasanas are Karmanga and for the purpose of Kriya. So, that was the sutra and thereby we saw all these vakchita, pranachita, manaschidadaya, all these agnis are upasya agnis or part of upasanas and they are independent and linga was given as yatkincha imani bhutani manasa sankalpayanti. The sankalpa with the mind, using the mind or sankalpa that is done in the mind, that itself shows that they are independent and thereby there is no dependency on karma at all. So lingam prakranat baliha was the hetu also quoted for linga to be considered as the primary hetu to conclude that upasanas are independent. Ittam siddhantam upakramya purvapakshiti. Having presented the siddhanta, now भगवान सूत्रकार रेजेस द पूर्वपक्ष विच गोज एज दिस पूर्व पक्ष सूत्र पूर्व विकल्प प्रकरणात् स्यात् क्रिया मानसवत् पूर्व विकल्प प्रकरणात् स्यात् क्रिया मानसवत्। सो पूर्व पक्षी सेज पूर्व विकल्प पूर्व इज पूर्वकांड कर्मकांड विच हैज गॉन बाय। सो पूर्व विकल्प दिस सूत्र इज पूर्व पक्ष सूत्र। सो इस इज पूर्व कर्म क्रिया विच हैज शोन अग्नि एज अंगा टू कर्म। अग्नि इज कर्मांग, यू हैव टू यूज अग्नि टू ऑफर एनी आहुति इनवोक द देवता इत्यादि। सो पूर्व डिस्कस्ड अग्नि द अग्नि विच हैज बीन डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर एज पार्ट ऑफ द क्रिया क्रियामय अग्नि। दिस विकल्प दिस अग्नि मनोमय अग्नि इज अ विकल्प। सो दिस मनोमय अग्नि दैट यू आर क्लेमिंग टू बी इंडिपेंडेंट उपासना इज नॉट रियली सो। वाई? बिकॉज इट इज अ विकल्प टू द फिजिकल अग्नि विच इज पार्ट ऑफ द क्रिया एंड देयर बाय इट इज कर्मांग। दिस इज नॉट एन इंडिपेंडेंट उपासना, इट इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन द कर्म विच हैज गॉन बाय। Why? What is the hetu? He has said prakranat, and we have already answered that prakranat linga is stronger. So he is giving prakrana as the hetu. The in that section, this is what the analysis stands out. So having said that, so on the account of the context, prakrana is the hetu of purvapakshi. And thereby kriya syat, he says kriya syat. Kriya syat means this kriya mayah karmangah syat agni. Which agni? The manomaya agni, which is in the upasana. And he gives the hetu. What is hetu? Manasavat, meaning manasa karmavat. So the padachita I have not done. Puro vikalpa prakaranat syat kriya manasavat. So like मानस क्रिया मानस कर्म मानसिक कर्म दिस उपासना इज ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ क्रिया, इट इज कर्मांग। दिस इज सूत्रार्थ। दिवृत्ति से संकल्पात्मक मनश्चिदादेह अग्नेय न स्वतंत्र। पूर्व पक्षी इज क्लेमिंग दीज अग्निज विच आर मनश्चिदादेह विच आर कल्पित इन दी मन दे आर नॉट स्वतंत्र, दे आर नॉट इंडिपेंडेंट। And what is the nature of this manomaya agni? It is sankalpatmaka. You are doing a sankalpa in the manaha, and sankalpa is part of the karma. If you look at it, many a place you have seen. So kintu ishtakabhi agnim chinute ishtakabhi agnim chinute iti prakrutasya purvasya kriyamayasya agnihe ayam vikalpaha sankalpatmaka agnihe. So vikalpa is sankalpatmaka agni. In the antakaran, in the mind, what you have is what is like this kintu ishtaka bhi agnim chinute. How do you do agni chayana? Agni chayana, the agni is invoked, physical agni is lit up using a homa kunda which is made up of ishtaka, made of bricks. So the agni in the bricks has to be use as karmanga to a kriya that you are doing. So iti prakrutasya purvasya kriyamayasya agni hai. That agni has dependency on kriya which you are going to do. It's a physical agni. So in that context prakruta, in that context, in that prakarana, what you have prakruta is in that prakarana. In that prakarana you have purva agni. So that is purvasya vikalpa. Purvasya meaning kriyamayasya. That purva gone by earlier agni which is a physical agni, tasya agni hai, of that agni ayam vikalpayam sankalpatmaka agni, this agni is vikalpa, the upasana antargata agni is vikalpa. Why so? Prakaranat. So it's an anga. This agni is also anga to karma which has gone by. Why? Because prakrana is like that. The context says so. Kriya and kriya syat meaning kriya maya eva syat. therefore the conclusion is this Agni is also what? Kriya only, meaning Kriyamaya, it is Karmanga. Now what you have said, Linga is stronger. Nacha Lingad Agni Nam Swatantriyam. This Linga won't work here, says the Puropakshi. And this is the reason, since he is arguing back, therefore we have seen the Siddhanta Sutra gone by earlier, and then the Puropaksha is objecting to that and says Linga, due to the Linga Hetu, Agni cannot have Swatantriya. Why? So Tasya Lingasya Manasika Agni Stuti Paratvena Vidhyeka Vakyataya Swartha Paratva Bhavatna Prakarana Badakatvam. So Puropakshi is very clear in his mind that Linga is stronger than Prakarana, I agree. But here that Linga will lead to Stuti of the Manasika Agni. So Linga, that it is a Sankalpa Ityadi, what you have, the Linga that you have given, this Yakincha Imani Bhutani Manasa Sankalpayanti. So this Kincha Imani Bhutani Manasa Sankalpayanti just tells you with the mind the Sankalpa is made of this Agni, that is just for the Stuti of this Manomaya Agni, and therefore you can only conclude that there is a Stuti. So Arthavada you can conclude, and if you conclude that it's an Arthavada, then what happens is that Arthavada does not have independent existence at all. Meaning Artha, where there is an Arthavada, it is not an independent statement. You cannot conclude that it is an independent Upasana. Why? Because wherever there is an Arthavada, we have seen earlier as to Swartha Paratva Abhavat, there is no Swartha in that statement. You have to see a dependent statement for such a Stuti, such an Arthavada. So he says Tasya Lingasya Manasika Agni Stuti Paratvena. This becomes a Hetu. Stuti para meaning it is committed to Stuti. So this statement Linga, the statement which is a Linga, which is a Vachaka Shabda, that is Vachaka for committed to Stuti. And thereby Manasika Agni Stuti. Give me just a moment, I have some someone to talk to. Just give me a moment. Am I audible? Satish ji, am I audible?
Yes. Yes, yes, Pran.
So, Tasya Lingasya Manasika Agni Stuti Paratvena. Since it is Stuti Para, therefore what this becomes a Hetu? For Vidhi Eka Vakyata. This will be the Hetu, since this Linga is committed to, this Linga is Hetu to reveal that there is commitment to Stuti. And therefore, the Stuti is what, like Vayu Vaik Kshepishta Devata Itivata. Like what, Vayu is Kshepishta Devata. Vayu is, so there is a mantra which says Vayu is the fastest Devata. What do you get out of it? Is it an independent statement for karma or upasana? No, it is not. Even if you imagine that the Vayu is the fastest Devata, still it is a Stuti. And since it is Stuti, therefore it will become Anga to something that has gone by, which is talking about Vayu. Similarly here, this Agni, which is Manasika Agni, it is being praised with this Vakya. With this, Vakya every way, this statement is a Vakya. So we don't have a better word. Unfortunately, this Vakya is a different kind of a Pramana in the Shruti Linga Vakya Prakrana Sthana Samakhyanam. So take it with a pinch of salt. When I say Vakya, it is not a Vakya Pramana. When I say Vakya Pramana, then it is this Vakya, Vakya Pramana, in the set of Pramanas that the Purva Mimamsa Sutra talks about. But this Vakya is just a general statement. What kind of Pramana it is? It is Linga. So this Linga will become one with the, will have Eka Vakyata with the Vidhi. So which is a Vidhi Vakya you have to search? With that vidhi vakya, the way Vayurvaik Shepishta Devata has ekavakyata, similarly this linga that you are talking about, sankalpayanti ityadi, manasa sankalpayanti, that will become one with the, you have to interpret it to one meaning, you have to interpret it along with another vakya, which is a vidhi vakya. And thereby vidhi vakyataya, this will become the second hetu. So linga is definitely stronger than prakarana, but it will lead to conclusion that it is praising manasika agni, and therefore that first hetu will lead to ekavakyata with the vidhivakya, and that therefore tritiya tells you another hetu vidhyekavakyataya. Through this second hetu you will land on swartha paratva abhava. So swartha paratva abhavat, it does not have independent existence at all. It has vidhi ekavakyata. It has ekavakyata with the vidhivakya, and therefore swartha, it has no independent meaning itself, let alone become an independent upasana. Therefore, na prakarana badakatva. Therefore, it will not contradict the prakarana also. In fact, it will make the prakarana interpretation stronger, which I am doing, says the पूर्वपक्षी. तस्मात् क्रिया अनुप्रवेशिनः एते अग्नयः मानसवत् मानसवत् यथा द्वादशाहे मनोग्रहं गृह्णामि इति श्रुतं मानसग्रहं द्वादशाह मध्यपातिनः दशमस्य अन्नः अंगम् तथा इमे अग्नयः प्रकृतकर्मशेषा इत्यर्थः. सो हाउ डू यू रीड दिस. तस्मात् क्रिया अनुप्रवेशि वेशिनः एते अग्नयः. These agnis, which are what? Kriya anupraveshi. They have entered into ekavakyata with the kriya vidhi, and therefore they are karmanga to kriya. They are part of karma, that is the kriya anupravesha. And these agnis, which manasika agnis, ete, are like manasa karma, manasika karma, manasavat. And thereby manasavat what? Prakrita karma sheshaha. These agnis are, conclusion is prakrita karma sheshaha. Whatever is in the context, the karma, that context is the main karma, and these upasanas are manasika karmas, which are having dependency on them. They are karmanga. Ityartha, this is what he is the construct. And what is the example given? Yatha dvadashahe in a somayaga, which goes across 12 days. Dvadasha is 12. Ahe, 12 days. So in this karma which goes across 12 days, that somayaga, there manograham granami is a statement there. Manograham granami. So manokalpitam, manograham sankalpitam granami. So there the statement says so, that there is sankalpa in the mind. Iti shrutam manasagraham. In this manner, what you hear, that manasa graha is what? Dvadasha aha madhyapatinaha dashamasya annaha angam. This manasa graham granami, this manasa graha, the manasika kalpana, is what? Is the somarasa, which is manograha. Somarasa is physical, but then manograham granami, I partake this sankalpita or kalpita somarasa. Where it is kalpita? Manasi kalpita. So manasa graham, what is being captured by the mind, that kind of, or kalpita by the mind, imagined by the mind, that kind of a somarasa granami, I am partaking. Iti shrutam, this is what you have heard now. And what is it? It will become a linga to understand what? Manasa graham dvadasha aha madhyapatina. In the 12 days, the 10th is in between. So madhyapati is dashama day, the 10th day. So that 10th day, somayaga, of 12 days has a 10th day. In that 10th day, of that 10th day, this will become Anga. This Manograham Granami will become Anga on that 10th day of that 10th day. Tatha ime Agnya. Similarly, these Agnis also, which are Manomaya Agni, are Prakruta Karma Shesha. They are dependent on the, they are Anga of the main karma. Kincha. Further, another Purva Paksha Sutra says Atidesha. Atidesha. And also due to Atidesha. Because this is an extension. He says there is a Atidesha. The karma has agnis. Those agnis, whatever are the characteristics of the physical agni, physical fire, there is an extension of these into the upasanas. The attributes are extended. Therefore, atidesha is also hetu. Atidesha cha, also due to atidesha. Vritti says, manasika agni na madhye ekaika evatavan yavanaso purvaha iti purvena ishtaka chitena agnina sampadika agnina sadrishya upadeshaccha tachyeshatva ityartha. Purva Pakshi says that these manasika agni that you have, what are these? They have some characteristics, because in sankalpa also you have to imagine fire. The characteristics of this fire has to be same as the, or similar to the characteristics of the physical agni. So this similarity, sadrushya is there, sadrushya upadeshaccha. You have to imagine sadrushya. You have to imagine the agni with similarities with the physical agni. So manasika agni na madhye, there are many agnis in the upasanas that you are doing. There ekaika eva tavan yavan asau purvaha, that physical agni which has gone by purva, yavan, as many things that are there in that particular agni, those many are in this as well. Tavan what? Ekaika eva. So here also you have meaning, as many agnis are there in the karma, so many you are imagining, and all the characteristics which are there you are imagining here with similarity. All to be done. Ekaika eva. There is one agni there, here also there is one agni. Whatever characteristics are there in the physical agni, here in the manasika agni also you have those characteristics. Iti purvena ishtaka chitena agnina sadrishyam. So there is a sadrishyam, similarity with which agni, with that agni which is ishtaka chita, purvena ishtaka chitena agnina, with the earlier agni, which is that agni, the physical agni, which is created with the bricks put together, within that it has been created. So sampadika agni nam is in sampad upasana. So there this sampad agni which is manomaya, so this agni is being imagined for upasana. It is being prescribed, that vidhi is given, sadrishya upadeshaccha. There is a upadesha, teaching of this upasana with similarity. Similarity is taught there, tachyeshatvam, and therefore tachyeshatvam. Similarity with whichever is taught, it becomes anga to that. So tachyeshatvam ityartha. There is karmangatvam of these upasanas. Ittam purva pakshe siddhanta iti. Now the purva paksha has been given. Siddhanta was also given earlier, but the purva pakshi said that no, I agree that the prakarana is not stronger than the linga, but linga will not conclude that independency that you are claiming, you are siddhanti, but it will only make my prakarana stronger, prakarana pramana stronger. Why? Because they are stuti para. Lingas are stuti para, and thereby ekavakyata will lead to karmangattva. Itham Purva Paksha Siddhanti. Now Siddhanti replies to this kind of an objection to linga being stronger than the prakrana, but still not conclusive enough for independency of upasanas. To that, Bhagavan Sutrakara says, vidyayavatu nirdharanat. Vidyayavatu nirdharanat. So Siddhanti says, vidya eva tu nirdharanat. Svidya eva. This is upasana. It is not karmanga. It is an independent upasana. And it is also knowledge of that upasana which is being given by sadrishya does not make it dependent on the karma. It is an independent upasana which is taught with similarities, and therefore vidya eva. This knowledge is for upasana alone, not to make it karmanga, and therefore svatantra. Tu is to refute the purvapaksha nirdharanat, due to nirdharana avadharana. That will be shown in the mantra which will be quoted in the vritti. So Bhagavan Sadashiva Brahmendra says, tuhu purvapaksha nirasartha. Tu is to refute the purvapaksha, the earlier two sutras. So vidyatmaka ete manaschidadeha svatantra eva. Svatantra eva. These manaschidadeha, these agnis are independent upasanas. They are independent to the agnis of the physical karma. Therefore, they are svatantra agnis, svatantra upasana dityartha. Vidyatmaka. They are the nature is upasana. The nature is to reveal something which is unknown. With an example of known, there is similarity. Therefore, vidyatmaka, the swarupa is vidya upasana of these agnis, and therefore they are svatantra eva. Eva. So, svatantra eva. Indeed, they are independent upasanas. Na karma anupraveshinaha. They are not karmanga. They are not part of karma. Kutaha. What is the hetu? Tete vidyachita eva iti avadharanat ityartaha. So nirdharana word has been used in the sutra, avadharana in the vritti, they have a same meaning. So nirdharana has been done. So that evakarena nirdharana has been done. Iti avadharana, avadharana, ascertainment has been done with evakara. Which evakara? This not the sutra evakara, because nirdharana is in the shruti. This vidya eva means to conclude, indeed this is vidya. And it is only an upasana, it is only independent upasana. How do you know that? Because such avadharana is there, nirdharana, ascertainment is there in shruti itself. Tete vidyachita eva has been said. This evakara is the nirdharana hetu. Avadharana hetu, it is ascertaining. It cannot be anything else. Because evakara shows tete vidyachitaha eva. These agnis, manaschidadeha agnis, are what? Svatantra. Why so? Because they are only vidyachita. They are only part of upasana, is a claim made by Shruti itself. Therefore, that avadharana evakara says that it cannot be sankalpatmaka sampadika agni as well as the physical agni's anga, physical karma's anga. It cannot be. Because avadharana is there ityartaha, and therefore evakara shrutya karma prakranam vadhyam iti bhava. So Purvapakshi is being answered as to linga that you think is making prakrana stronger will not work. Why? Because shruti also is there. There is a sakshat shruti which is a stronger pramana than prakrana and linga both, and your prakrana cannot be strengthened by linga. However, the shruti is contradicting your prakrana and linga is in line with shruti. Therefore, the linga will be made stronger by the shruti. From the Purvapakshi's perspective, the linga makes the prakrana that he is using stronger, in the sense is validating that. It cannot make it stronger because it is already stronger. Linga is stronger than the prakrana. So, he is saying that prakrana argument is strengthened. And Siddhanti is saying Linga cannot make Prakarana stronger if it is contrary to the Shruti. So Linga is in line with Shruti, and Prakarana, which is the Pramana in the set of Pramana, if you look at Shruti, Linga, Vakya and Prakarana. So Prakarana, which is fourth drawn out, that is strengthened by Linga by Stuti Paratva, is a claim made by Purva Pakshi. Siddhanti says that however your Prakarana is contradicting Shruti, whereas Linga is in line, what I have analyzed, that is in line with Shruti, and Shruti contradicts Prakarana. So Linga will not make your Prakarana stronger, it will weaken it further, and Shruti is a direct Pramana where you do not have to imagine anything else. As you go further out, you have to imagine more, and you have to finally imagine a Shruti in all cases. That Shruti need not be imagined because you have Evakara Shruti that says that Evakara Shrutya Karma Prakaranam Bhajyam Iti Bhavaha. This Prakarana of Karma is no longer Pramana for concluding Ekavakyata also, and to conclude that there is Karmangatvam thereby. So this Evakara, I marked it, highlighted it because I wanted to show that this Evakara is the Shruti Antargata Evakara, not this Evakara over here. Although it may be obvious, but sometimes, you know, sleepy reading may make it little difficult to see which Evakara. So Evakara Shruti is there. It is already saying Shrutya, but then to clarify, I have just, it's a good way to mark and understand as to where this Evakara, easy to find also in study and teaching. Kincha Linga api Bhajyam Ityaha, and Linga has already been given, he is just repeating that. Kincha Linga api Bhajyam Ityaha. So Bhagavan Sutrakara says Darshana cha. Darshana is Linga which has been given. Darshana, we have shown Linga also, Darshana cha. What is that? Manaschidadinam Swatantra Jnapaka Lingasya Praguktasya Darshana cha Ityartha. Which has already been, Darshanath means, since it has already been seen and shown to the Purva Pakshi in the last part of Antargata Sutra, which is the 44th Sutra. So, Linga Bhuyastvad Tadhi Baliyastadapi, there, this Yatkinche Imani Bhutani Manasa Sankalpayanti, Linga was shown, and that is the Darshana there. Manaschidadinam Swatantri Jnapaka Lingasya Praguktasya Darshana Chaityartha. So Darshana otherwise elsewhere would mean Shruti. Here the Sutra Darshana shows that in the 44th Sutra it has been shown, it has been seen. Darshana means it has been seen. It is seen. What is seen? The Linga is seen, Prauktasya Darshana, which has already been stated. It has been seen there as to Linga, which is stronger than Prakarana, is Jnapaka of Svatantrya. It is revealer of independency of the Upasana of Manaschita Adinam Agninam. So of the Manaschita Agni Tyadi, which has been shown in the 44th Sutra itself. So that is the 48th Sutra. Further, to make the argument stronger, because Purva Pakshi has brought up two more sutras. So we cannot have more Purva Pakshi sutras and Siddhanti just getting by a sutra or two. So kincha vakyadapi tad bhajyam ityaha. So now not only Shruti and Linga, but there is also Vakya Pramana. Vakya Pramana here, Vakya is Pramana. Vakya Pramana adapi tad bhajyam. Tad bhajyam is, tat is Prakaranam. Prakaranam bhajyam. Shrutyadi baliyastvachana vadaha. Shrutyadi baliyastvachana vadaha. So Shrutyadi baliyastvachana vadaha. Therefore, for what reason? Shruti Ityadi are stronger. Shruti, Linga, Vakya are stronger. All three are stronger than the Prakarana, Pramana that Purva Pakshi is claiming to lead to Karmangatvam of Upasanas. Therefore, what they are being stronger, Shrutyadi, Shruti and Adi Shabdena, Linga, Vakya or Grahanam. Linga and Vakya are also stronger. Therefore, na badaha, meaning there is no issue with the सिद्धांति इज इंटरप्रिटेशन, द पूर्वपक्षी कैनॉट काउंटर एंड से दैट योअर लॉजिक इज काउंटर्ड बाय यू नो काउंटर्ड और रिफ्यूटेड. सो दिस न बाधा हियर इज दिस बाधा इज न बाधा मीनिंग इट इज नॉट टू बी रेड एज दि बाध्यम विद दिस बाध्यम हियर द बाध्यम इज लिंगादपि प्रकरण से बाध्यम एंड हियर वॉट इज बींग शोर श्रुति वाक्य श्रुति लिंग एंड वाक्य आर बलिया दे आर स्ट्रॉन्गर एंड देयर फोर वॉट न बाधा इज वॉट न बाधा ऑफ द सिद्धांत सिद्धांत बाधा नास्ति दैट इज द मीनिंग हियर आदि शब्द न लिंग वाक्य और ग्रहणम. सो आदि स्टैंड्स फॉर लिंग एंड वाक्य. सो श्रुति लिंग एंड वाक्य ऑल थ्री आर स्ट्रॉन्गर बलिया देन द प्रकरण प्रमाण. श्रुति लिंगे प्राउक्त श्रुति एंड लिंग हैज ऑलरेडी बीन शोन वाक्य हैज नॉट बीन शोन. सो वाक्य प्रमाण इज शोन इन दिस सूत्र. सो भगवान वृत्ति भगवान सदाशिव ब्रह्मेन्द्र से वृत्ति विद्या हे वैते एवं विदश्चिता भवन्ति इति एतद् वाक्यं मनश्चिदादीनां स्वातंत्र्यं बोधयत् प्रकरणं बाधयति. सो प्रकरण प्रमाण शोन बाय द पूर्वपक्षी इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट यू हैव टू पुट देम टुगेदर द फिजिकल अग्नि एंड दी इमेजिन और दी उपासना मानसिक अग्नि शुड बी पुट टुगेदर विद द फिजिकल अग्नि दैट इज नॉट द केस एंड प्रकरण बाधयति. वॉट काउंटर्स दिस प्रकरण प्रमाण श्रुति एंड लिंग हैज ऑलरेडी बीन शोन दिस वाक्य ऑल्सो विद्यया हे वैते एवं विदश्चिता भवन्ति विद्यया ही एव एते एवं विदः चिता भवन्ति. सो दि एवं विद वन हु नोज दि विद्या दिस विद्या उपासना एज टॉट एवं विद ही इज एन एवं विद. सो दिस एवं विद एंड व्हाट डज ही नो विद्या ही एव विद्या नॉट ही एव विद्या ह एव इंडीड थ्रू दिस विद्या दिस अग्निस चिताः भवन्ति बाय द एवं विद वन हु नोज इन दिस मैनर बाय हिम द अग्निस अग्नि चयन गेट्स डन विथ व्हाट विथ विद्या अलोन ऑल दीज अग्निस आर किंडल्ड द फायर ऑल दीज फायर्स आर किंडल्ड विद द विद्या थ्रू दी विद्या इति एतद् वाक्यम दिस वाक्य ऑल्सो व्हाट शोज दिस अग्नि विद्या इज देयर एंड देन वन डज द अग्नि चयन मेंटली. सो मनश्चितादीनां स्वातंत्र्यं बोधयत् प्रकरणं बाधयति बोधयत् वाइल रिवीलिंग. सो शत्रंत पद बोधयत् वाइल रिवीलिंग इट इज निजंत. सो कॉजेटिव रिवीलिंग बोधयत वाइल रिवीलिंग इज द मीनिंग. सो शत्रंत पद सो वर्तमान काल वाइल इट इज रिवीलिंग वॉट स्वातंत्र्यम विच हू इज द रिवीलर द वाक्य. सो वाक्य प्रमाण दिस वाक्य प्रमाण विद्या हैवेते एवं विदश्चिता भवन्ति दिस वाक्य बोधयत वाइल रिवीलिंग वॉट रिवीलिंग स्वातंत्र इंडिपेंडेंसी ऑफ मनश्चिदादि अग्नि. सो दि मेंटली किंडल्ड फायर्स अग्निस वाइल रिवीलिंग दैट प्रकरण बाधेति इट काउंटर्स द प्रकरण प्रमाण दैट द पूर्वपक्षी इज क्लेमिंग causes dependency. The vakya which is establishing independency of the upasanas while it is revealing that independency itself it will counter the prakarana leading to dependency on karma of these agnis. Tatha cha etesham shruti linga vakyanam baliyastvat because shruti linga and vakya pramanas all of these pramanas are what etesham baliyastvat being stronger durbalena karma prakaranena na manaschidadinam swatantra badha ityartha. So swatantra badha is not there which is this Siddhanta, there is no counter or refutation of the conclusion of the Siddhanti that this Manaschida Agni is Upasana are independent. They are independent. Agnis are independent in Upasanas. Upasanas are independent. And thereby Durubala Karma Prakarana cannot oppose this conclusion of the Siddhanti. Karma Prakarana. Because it is a context of karma, Upasanas have to be karmanga. That is not the case. They are independent still. Ityartha. Yattu lingasti stuti paratvam. Purupakshi says, what about the linga being stuti para? It is stuti para. I have shown you with an example. Like Vayurvek Shepishta Devata. Similarly, this is stuti para. Manaschita Agni Sankalpa is praising the Manomaya Agni. What about that? Tanna. Siddhanti says that is not the case at all. Why? Tasya vidhi pratya samipya abhavat apurvartha vidhayakatvad ityartha. It is an independent vidhi. Upasana is an independent vidhi. Why? It is not stuti para. You cannot have ekavakyata with karmakanda vakya of Agni chayana there. Why? Because this statement of Upasana Manomaya Agni is a linga, and it is not close to Vidhi Pratyaya, which has gone by, where you understand there is a Vidhi Vakya of Karma Kanda. This is not very close to it at all. It may be in the same context, but it is not close. It is not the next statement or the closest statement. And therefore, there is abhava of samipya to pratyaya of the vidhi. Where you get an understanding of vidhi of karma, kanda, agni, there you do not have samipya of this particular manomaya agni, linga. And thereby, this statement, when you analyze the manomaya agni upasana statement, when you analyze the sankalpayanti, manasa sankalpayanti, there, apurvartha vidhayakatvad ityartha. It reveals something which is apurvartha. It gives you vidhi. Why does it give you vidhi? As in, you do this upasana in this manner, an independent upasana, where you do upasana in the manner, in which manner? Where you imagine the agnis which have characteristics similar to the karmakanda agni which has gone by. When you get this vakya, did you know earlier that you have to imagine Agni? You did not know. Therefore, it is apurva, prior unknown. And whatever is prior unknown, for that Shruti becomes pramana. So this linga will become pramana for its being an independent vidhi. Therefore, vidhayakatva. Shruti is telling you, do this. You did not know. So when you hit that statement, it makes independent sense as to imagine Agni. Now, can you imagine these Agnis without the karma? You are sitting in your Sandhyavandana, let's say, and you imagine many things. Shruti says you imagine Agni. If you do not have an Agni, it is not that you cannot imagine. So, independently you can imagine. What is the harm there? Therefore, when Shruti is saying something which you did not know that you have to imagine Agni, and Shruti says you imagine the Agni, then it becomes a vidhi. Therefore, apurvartha vidhayakatvad, it is not having samipya with the purva karmakanda Agni vidhi, and this long drawn out statement gives you something that you did not know. Therefore, it will become a vidhi, and thereby it's an independent upasana. So, this is the clincher argument of the Siddhanti, summing all that Shruti, Linga and Vakya quoted. Itopi manaschidadinam swatantrem ityaha. Siddhanti does not stop there. He says, for this reason also these are independent upasanas. Why? Because see, why so many sutras? Another reason is because most of the upasanas are karmanga, which I have discussed. Sorry, there is some issue with the car. Somebody's car is, some alarm is going on. So, itopi manaschidadinam swatantrem ityaha. For this reason also, quoted in the next sutra, there is independency of these upasanas, manovayagnis, anubandhadibhyah prajnanantara prutaktvavad drishtascha taduktam. Anubandhadibhyah prajnanantara prutaktvavad drishtascha taduktam. Oh, I just already overshot the time to go to the next part. Huh? But anyway, since I have read this, let's do padachyeda and look at the basic meaning. Anubandhadibhyah prajnanantara prutaktvavad drishtah cha tad uktam. So anubandhadibhyah hetubhyah, we'll see what these hetus are. There are hetus quoted, anubandhadi hetus, these are hetus, heto panchami bahuvachana here. So at least three hetus are there. Prajnantara prutaktvavat, like what? Prajnantara, anya prajna, prajnantaram, another section where some knowledge, you get some knowledge about vidya, about or prajna, about some upasana. So this prajnantara is what? Shandilya vidya. So shandilya adi vidya is there, that is shandilya adi prajna. There you get some kind of understanding, and thereby prajnantara pruthak to what? Like a separate upasana seen in Shandilyadi upasana, similarly, that is an example, drishtaha cha taduktam. It is seen in those sections. We'll see in the next part as to what is seen, where it is seen, and taduktam, it has been stated. So we'll see karma kande. You see in Prathama Kanda, in Jaimini Sutra, you see, so Taduktam is through Jaimini Sutra, it is shown that Taduktam. So we have seen Taduktam, it has been stated. So in Purvamimamsa itself, it has been stated. Drishtascha, where so Rajasuyam Prastutya, Shrutaya Aveshtehe Brahmana Adikartrukaya Ityadi, there Drishta, Utkarsha Drishta, so that is Drishta. So in Puru Mimamsa itself, Taduktam, what has been said? Drishtascha, what has been seen in the Shruti. So in Karmakanda, what has been seen? Drishtaha. Thereby, karmas are separated as well. Karmas are also separated as not karmanga, there is some separation seen. And Taduktam, it has been stated by Bhagavan Jaimini in the Puru Mimamsa Sutra itself. And similarly, what? Prajnantara prutaktvavat, like another vidya seen elsewhere, this also anubandhadibhya hetubhya, you can see that this manaschidadi upasana agnis, these manaschidadi upasana antargata agnis have swatantriyam. So karmakanda example will be given now as to how karma is also seen as a separate karma. Even in the same context, you see, one karma is separated out from the other. So the example quoted will be, some karmas can be done by only some varnas, some karmas are common to the trivarnikas. So even if it is in the same context, still some separation is done with karma as to who is the adhikari. Similarly here, upasanas also, although they are in the same prakarana, they can be separated as independent, there is no angangi bhava there. So we'll look at the vritti in the next part. Amna yanto sam siddham adhi madhyanta varjitam ananda ghana mahapurna matme jyoti rupasmihi. Namaste. Dhanyavada.
Dhanyavada. Namaste.